Good morning everyone, how are you all? So in today's video, we will discuss about a very important topic from class 12, chapter VPI, the binding energy curve. So this topic is very important. In the previous video, we discussed about the concept of binding energy, concept of mass defect, concept of binding energy per nucleon, and how binding energy is basically associated or mass defect is basically associated with the stability of the nucleus. So through those studies only we generated this curve, and this curve actually tells us so many things about the nucleus. So this curve is very important for your exam point of view also, and apart from that it is very important for your higher studies purpose also. So, I will just discuss a brief description about this binding energy curve and the value of binding energy per nucleon. This graph is basically drawn between two parameters. On the y-axis, you can see binding energy per nucleon. Okay, it is given in mega electron volt that we have already calculated. So, it is given in mega electron volt, and in the x-axis, on the x-axis you can see the graph is drawn on the basis of mass number. That is on the basis of mass number, because mass number is the sum of protons and neutrons, nucleons, and they constitute the nucleus. So therefore we describe this on the basis of mass number and binding energy per nucleon. So why this graph is only drawn on the basis of mass number? Because nucleus constraint of proton and neutron, that are, they are called nucleons, and that is the nucleus number. We can say the mass number is there. So this graph is drawn between it. Now the value of binding energy per nucleon basically gives a measure of the stability of the nucleus. That is very important part. That binding energy per nucleon for any particular nucleus gives the stability of the nucleus. Greater the value of binding energy per nucleon, more is the stability of the nucleus. I repeat, greater the value of binding energy per nucleon of the nucleus, the stability will also be greater. So it is directly proportional to the binding energy per nucleon. So here I will just describe briefly about this. So you can see hydrogen 1H1 is here with the least binding energy per nucleon, and it suddenly rapidly increased for the helium. Now here you can see some peaks over here, and some of them are down. So some peaks are there, this and this. Now you can see helium 4, carbon 12 and 16 O. They are at peaks, and other subordinate of or the next nuclei of them are at a lower energy level. Right, if you compare lithium and helium, helium has a higher energy level than lithium. If you compare carbon and nitrogen, the carbon has a higher binding energy per nucleon, that the stability is more. Now why this variation is there? So this variation is because of the number of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus. If you compare with lithium and helium, the number of protons is equal to number of neutron. In the case of these peak nucleus, you can see oxygen, number of proton 8, number of neutron 8. You can see carbon, carbon number of proton 6, right, number of neutron 6. So therefore, because of the Coulombian force or attractive force, right, this binding energy per neutrons also vary. So when there is equal number of protons and neutrons, they have a higher binding energy per nucleon. That means they are more stable as compared to other nucleus. Right? Then we see a gradual increase in the binding energy per nucleons from here. Okay, and it goes maximum for iron around. It is around your 8.7 mega electron volt. Right, for iron it is around 8.7 mega electron volt, and iron is supposed to be the most stable nuclei in the periodic table because of the binding energy per nucleon. It has the maximum binding energy per nucleon around 8.7 mega electron volt. Therefore, it is considered as a most stable nuclei. Clear? After that, gradually the value is on a smooth curve. It keeps on decreasing with the decrease of the mass number. So the value of binding energy per nucleon gradually decreases with the increase of mass number. Right? Till 120, it's almost on the same curve. It is right, and then it keeps on decreasing and reaches to uranium 235. It is around 7.6 mega electron volt. Right, so it keeps on decreasing, and reaches to a value of 7.6 mega electron volt for uranium 238, which is a radioactive substance. You already know. So there are some important features, as I have already discussed the features in this. So there are some important features also that, except for some nuclei like helium, carbon, and oxygen, the value of binding energy per nucleon lie on or near the curve. So except this I have already told you, these three nuclei lie on the same curve. If I would have drawn this curve like this, so it would have been on the same curve. So why the reason behind that, that also I have told you, okay, why is it so? The peak value is why the peak is given to them. Then we have binding energy for mass number 30 to 120. Increase from 30, from here you can see it will be 30 around here. So from here till here around, this will be 120. So in this particular section, the binding energy remain almost constant. Although it vary, because iron has a maximum binding energy, although it vary, but almost it remain constant. And another feature, you can see that nuclei less than 30. This side. And more than 120. More than 120 in this side. Okay, they have less value of binding energy per nucleon. Right, so these are basic features of this binding energy curve that is very important. Now, because of this second, the last point, because of this point that nuclei less than 30 and more than 20. Actually, binding energy per nucleon curve also describe about the nucleus tendency for fission and fusion reaction. Fission and fusion reaction you must have studied in class 10. Nuclear fission is basically when a big or big nucleus breaks into two small nucleus generating some neutron. So that is called nuclear fission. And in fusion, two small nucleus combine together to form a bigger nuclei. So that is basically nuclear fission and fusion reaction. So on the basis of stability and binding energy per nucleons, the nucleus, this curve also defines, this curve also gives information regarding which particular nuclei is prone to nuclear fusion reaction and which will be have a tendency of a nuclear fission reaction. So in this study it was found that these nuclei, uranium, thorium, radium, polonium, they will be, because of their less stability and inter-Coulombian force is also very less, so they can easily break out into two small nucleus in order to gain more stability. Ab yahan se break hogar ke वो दो छोटे न्यूक्लियस में बनेंगे, तो उनका जो छोटे न्यूक्लियस हैं उनका एटॉमिक नंबर, जो मास नंबर होगा, वो यहाँ पर लाइक है और यहाँ पर जो है क्या है, बाइंडिंग एनर्जी पर न्यूक्लियस ज्यादा है. ठीक है, सो इसीलिए ये जो न्यूक्लियस है दे आर प्रोन टू फ्यूजन रिएक्शन बिकॉज दे ब्रेक्स दे आर लेस स्टेबल ब्रेक्स इनटू मोर स्टेबल एटम्स इन मोर स्टेबल न्यूक्लियस राइट सो देयर फॉर दिस काइंड ऑफ न्यूक्लियस आर प्रोन टू फ्यूजन रिएक्शन सिर्फ सिमिलरली ओवर हियर हाइड्रोजन न्यूट्रॉन प्रोटॉन दे ऑल कंबाइन टुगेदर टू फॉर्म हीलियम okay two deuterons combined together to form helium 2h1 plus 2h1 your gives it gives 4he2 so less stable hydrogen deuteron is less stable and when two deuteron less stable nucleus they combine together to form a nucleus which is at a higher stability So they are prone to nuclear fusion. They are prone to. They have a tendency to combine together, right? So this is also studied under this curve only that which nucleus are prone or they have a tendency to add on when nucleus combine together. That particular process is called nuclear fusion, and when a particular nucleus splits, so the process is known as nuclear fission. So this graph also. Tells us about that which particular nucleus are having a tendency for fusion and fusing. So this is very important topic, bending and energy curve. So these are salient features which I told you. The curve I have already explained. So go through it completely. Next we will discuss about radioactivity and laws of radioactivity. That is very important chapter in the whole topic also, right? So for today, that's all. We will discuss it later. Thank you.